I woke up
in a telephone pole.
Ah, where? Oh God.
I didn't know that I was asleep. My name is Mike Kaplan, and this is the time I almost got out of a ticket.
By dying.
The year was 1996. And during that year, I learned to drive. I was working at a summer camp. It was an overnight sleepaway camp. I was a counselor. After the kids go to bed, nobody's watching the counselors. I snuck out. I don't know if it was sneaking, but I guess technically, what could go wrong? I drove to my girlfriend's. She was about an hour away. We were breaking up that summer, but I think we hadn't yet. So I think we had a nice time. And I was at her home until about 2 in the morning. Just like a horror movie, a beautiful love scene. And then,
disaster.
At this point in the story, I am still okay. Ready to make that 1 hour uneventful drive back to the summer camp along what was, I believe, a highway, a Connecticut highway, a dirt path. It wasn't well lit. There weren't tons of lights, but I had my car's trusty headlights. It was a new car. We were both in great shape. Whizzing down the road at a breakneck 40-something miles an hour, I go approximately the speed limit. Getting back to camp, making good time. The road is fine, I'm fine. Just whizzing by closed business after closed business, fences, open fields.
Buildings, non-buildings.
Connecticut, the land of buildings and non-buildings. And then all of a sudden, I woke up, adrenaline coursing through my veins. Normally, I'm awake while driving, and I was still driving. My head snapped up because apparently it had been down.
Whew, oh boy, okay.
Man, imagine if I'd fallen asleep for more than a split second. There could have been real trouble.
Lesson learned.
That's the only time it'll ever happen. Don't change anything that you're doing. Probably open the window to get some cool breeze in there. Keep that breeze in the old face. Totally fine. Gonna make it back. And then,
Oh God, where am I? Oh!
I woke up again in a telephone pole. I mean, not in it, but definitely they're pretty close. If you were at a high school dance, they would definitely try to separate you. They'd be like, hey, not enough room for the Holy Ghost there. This is a Holy Ghost story. This car would have gotten that telephone pole pregnant. My face, I realized, had been half singed from the airbag. My seatbelt, I'm glad I was wearing, but also my chest was extremely bruised from it. I was okay because of the safety equipment, and the only injuries were also from the safety equipment. Real love-hate relationship. Like, will they or won't they? Thank you, safety equipment. I looked around, I couldn't open the door. The car was not in a shape where that could happen. I climbed out my window, which I think did open or wasn't there anymore. I surveyed my further external to the car surroundings, and I saw that across the street, there was a business.
24-hour towing. We specialize in collisions.
That's exactly what I need. And I ran over, and the door was locked, and they were closed. 24 hours. But which hours? Good news, the police showed up. At that time, it was also sort of a bittersweet thing. I was both in and out of trouble. Anyway, the cop was like, hello?
Do you need to go to the hospital? I'm like, I think I'm okay. He's like, okay, we're gonna write you a ticket then. I'm like, if it's a choice between a ticket and the hospital, one hospital, please.
They gave me a ticket for making an illegal turn. It's apparently against the law in Connecticut to turn off the road through a fence into a telephone pole without signaling. The good news is I am alive. I'm not dead. I'm here to tell the tale, but barely. Bad news is I got that ticket. Life is just a series of tickets that you have to pay until you pay the final ticket. But when you die, then no more tickets. Thank you.